In November, Austinites will vote on a $925 million bond package.
But how is that divvied up, and what are we paying for?
And what are we paying for?
And what are we paying for?
At the top of the bond ballot, $250 million for affordable housing. It's the biggest housing bond ever put before city voters, and it's meant to allow more people to actually stay in the city limits instead of being pushed out by the high cost of housing.
$160 million goes to transportation. So rather than build new infrastructure, this money would go to repair things like roads, bridges, and sidewalks. But also, a lot of that money would be used to pay for a new bridge over Redbud Isle, a notion that not everybody's thrilled about, since many people who use the bridge live west of the lake and don't pay City of Austin taxes. $149 million for parks and facilities. And a good chunk of that money will help repair some of Austin's leakiest pools.
$128 million for libraries and cultural centers. Shh. Geez, all right. This will get divided between several cultural centers around town, including the Asian American Resource Center and the George Washington Carver Museum. Roughly $34 million will go towards converting the old Central Public Library into a place where the Austin History Center can house its archives.
$184 million for flood mitigation and open space. Areas of Austin are prone to flooding, Waller Creek, for example. In the past, the city has purchased homes that have continuously flooded. This money would pay for additional buyouts, plus buying open space, and paying for drainage improvements.
$38 million will go to public safety. That money will go to the Austin Fire Department and EMS to renovate their stations.
$16 million for Health and Human Services.
What? $16 million for Health and Human Services. That bond will fund a public health center in Southeast Austin in the Dove Springs neighborhood.
All seven bonds are on the November ballot in Austin.